Another Sunday. Happy Sunday. How you doing, Rue? Me too. I'm so happy. Let's stand up because we're gonna worship. Ooh, ooh, ooh,
ooh. Brit, Cray, ready or not? Yeah. Let's go.
I tried to cover my shine.
There's no point in hiding it. It's everything I am. The source of all my hope, and it's the reason why I stand. I pledge allegiance to being somebody real. There's no more holding it back. I'm showing them how I feel. Cause love is more than a word. It's a noun and a verb. And hiding is absurd. You heard?
Why are you bullying me?
Oh, oh, oh. Look at that. Everyone's jumping around. Woohoo! We all love to worship Jesus. How you doing today, Miss Emily?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing good. How you doing, Rue? Me too. Same. Everybody's tired. Anyway.
Holler.
What are we talking about today, Miss Emily?
Today, we are going to talk about forgiveness. We are going to talk about how we should forgive others because God forgives us all the time, every time.
Huh. That is so great. What?
Why'd you do that?
Oh, because I felt like it.
That was mean. Now I can't drink my drink because it's on the floor.
Oh. Well, sorry about that.
I definitely don't forgive you because now I'm super thirsty.
Well, that kind of hurts my feelings. I think I need to leave and come back. And I'm taking Rue because she's That's... my friend. She would forgive me. We'll be back.
As I was trying to say, there's a story in the Bible where Jesus tells everyone how many times you should forgive other people. And he talks about how there was a king and he had a man come to him that owed him $1 million. A million. I don't have $1 million. Do you have $1 million? That's a lot of dollars. So, that man asked, please forgive my debt, please. And the king said, okay. And then that man left and beat up a guy who owed him some money, like $5. Needless to say, the king found out and he was very mad. And Jesus tells us that we should forgive people 70 times 7. Do you know what 70 times 7 is? It's a lot. If you know the math, you should tell me. But we have to remember that Jesus died on the cross, so our sins can always be forgiven, no matter what. And this story is all about that, so go and watch it.
Stories of the Bible. The parable of the unforgiving servant. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like walking on water.
Oh, hey guys.
And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, Jesus was talking with his disciples and teaching them when Peter asked,
Jesus?
How often should I forgive someone who sins against me? 7 times? Jesus said, no, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Then Jesus told a parable. He said, the kingdom of heaven can be compared to a king who decided to get his money back that he had let his servants borrow. While the king was doing this, one of the servants who owed him $1 million was brought in.
$1 million, please?
The servant couldn't pay, so the king ordered that he be sold, along with his family and everything he owned, to pay the debt.
Wait, please!
But the servant begged the king, please be patient with me, and I will pay it all. Then his king was filled with pity for him, and he let him go and forgave his debt. But when the man left the king, he went to a fellow servant who owed him a few $1,000s.
Hi? Come here, Will.
He grabbed him and demanded that he pay him back immediately.
Oh, wait, please.
His fellow servant begged for a little more time. He said, be patient with me and I will pay it.
No.
But the servant wouldn't wait. He had the man arrested and put in prison until the debt could be paid in full. When some of the other servants saw this, they were very upset. They went to the king and told him everything that had happened. Then the king called in the man he had forgiven and said, you evil servant, I forgave you that tremendous debt because you pleaded with me. Shouldn't you have mercy on your fellow servant, just as I had mercy on you? Then the angry king sent the man to prison to be punished until he had paid all that he owed. Jesus then said, that's what my heavenly Father will do to you if you refuse to forgive your brothers and sisters from your heart.
Wow, that video was great. I love those little videos. They really help me learn more about what they're trying to tell me. I'm so thankful to learn more about forgiveness. I think forgiveness is really hard. Like, I know that sometimes people are just mean and I don't want to forgive them. I want them to be hurt because they hurt my feelings. But sometimes not forgiving someone only hurts yourself. And you know, during the video, I was really thinking about what happened with Mr. Chris, and I really should have forgiven him. I really want to drink my juice, and he knocked on the floor and I felt really mad, so that's what I said, and I did not mean it. Hopefully he'll forgive me. But right now we're going to worship, so we're going to worship and then hopefully he'll come back. I'm going to go see.
And they are inside your head. You got a voice that says you won't get past this one. You won't win your freedom. It's like a constant war, and you wanna settle that score. But you're bruised and beaten, and you feel defeated. This goes out to the heaviest heart. Put it in your past. Oh, feel the winter leaving. It's redemption season. Long live the young at heart. Cheers to a brand new start. We're revived and breathing to live a life of freedom.
Hello?
Hello? Miss Emily?
Mr. Chris?
Do you want to build a snowman?
I think it's too hot for that.
We're just kidding.
Oh my gosh.
Hello?
He scared me.
Sorry.
Hi.
Sorry. Wrong video.
Yeah. You're good. So I'm so glad that you're here because we watched a video and, you know, I feel so bad because I should have said, I'm sorry for being so snotty. And when you said you were sorry for spilling my juice, I should have said, it's okay, because it was okay. It's not a big deal.
I appreciate that, Miss Emily, and I forgive you. But I'm sorry too. There wasn't any reason to knock your juice down.
It's okay. I forgive you.
Thanks. You know, Rue and I were listening to the video slash watching it. It was really, 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 really good.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, just you have to forgive people and don't keep tally marks of how many times you've forgiven somebody. It doesn't matter if it's 70 times 7, which is a lot still, but it doesn't matter because you forgave them, so it's over. So this week's memory verse, everybody, is Matthew 18, 21 to 22. Then Peter came to Jesus and asked, Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother or sister who sins against me? 7 times? I've forgiven my brother 7 times. Jesus answered, I tell you not 7 times, but 7 times 70. Wow. That is so much. Matthew 18, 21 to 22. That is the memory verse.
That's the memory verse. Don't forget to memorize the verse, post a video, because we have a lot of surprises at our house and we're trying to take them to your house, but you gotta do the video.
Do the video.
Okay.
Miss Emily, would you like some of my juice? There's still some left because I spilled yours.
Thank you. That's so nice. Thank you.
We love you guys so much, and we'll see you next time.
Bye. Have a good week. I love you. The backseat driver.